Commander Fillion, this is Dr. Weaver and NASA Ground Control. Ground Control to Commander Fillion, do you read me?
I read you loud and clear, Dr. Weaver.
Excellent. How's the weather on Mars today?
Leave you, sly dog. You know there's no weather under the dome.
I hate to praise my own design, but we do have a nice dome. Even if people on NASA are calling us the Benchworm Mars Colony, the BT Mars Colony, there are a lot of mean sports analogies going around.
Well, don't listen to them. They made such a big deal over their last time with the big trained scientists.
But if humanity goes to live on the majestic red planet, who is humanity? Not scientists, but normal people, common folk. It's my mission to prove that anyone can sustain themselves on Mars. And I've decided that your mission as their astronaut guide will be to help these people grow the very first eggplant in space.
An eggplant? Really?
Somebody already did a zucchini.
This is madness, Doc. Can we even get any Parmesan up here?
I promise I will devise you some type of Parmesan as soon as this colony produces eggplant for NASA.
I guess even regular people can't mess with an eggplant that bad.
That's the spirit.
Oh, they're so stupid, though.
What's that?
I mean, best colonists ever had, top 10, no doubts.
Okay, well, you know, I was a little sad that NASA wouldn't let me go to Mars and run the colony myself. They think I'm a dreamer, a crackpot. But if it wasn't to be me, I'm glad it's you. I know you'll take care of things.
Right. Yeah. Okay.
And please remind everyone that we can send them any of the comforts of home that they want in the shuttle. Would you? Favorite snacks, music, anything like that.
Sure, but don't expect them to thank you. All they do is like to complain.
Really? You didn't note any complaints in the captain's log.
Oh, I like to attend to them personally. But you don't worry. I got everything under control.
Are they listening to you?
I'm the commander. Of course they are.
Okay, well, all the same, I'm interested to have the colonists start making the reports to NASA themselves in this next phase of the experiment.
Right, and about that, you know, you might hear some stuff.
What kind of stuff?
Mostly about how great it's going. Well, no, there's a Martian dust storm. I don't know what it is. It's getting really bad over here. I don't know. I gotta go. I'll see you later.
How peculiar.
Ground Control to Mars, NASA to Mars, calling this Sam. Do you read me?
Yes, I read you. This is Sam.
We're all excited for your report today. You received the instructions from NASA to construct the irrigation device to water that.
Yeah, well, I already finished it.
Well, this is very impressive. A flux apaculizer is very complex. Were you some kind of engineer?
Nah, I'm in sales, but I fixed our soda stream once.
You know, the NASA guys who were working on the other colony were saying we couldn't do it at all.
Shh, ridiculous.
This will show Philip who's working on the Junior Varsity Mars colony.
Is that what they call us?
Well, the important thing is the flux apaculizer. You got all the step-by-step instruction packet, right? The ones that look like this?
Yeah, you sure sent a lot of them, but no big deal.
Oh, well, yeah. Okay, wow. And there were the diagrams?
Yeah, for sure.
Wow, well, these even look daunting to me. Run into any questions with these?
Absolutely none. I was surprised. It was incredibly easy.
Well, excellent. Wow. All right. Well, show me what you came up with.
Okay, just be aware that as I was going, I made a couple of modifications that I think will really improve the design, but here she is.
Wow. Okay, wow.
I know, right?
Sam, I have a couple of questions.
Yeah, you see, I drew the flames on the side myself.
Sam, is that tape?
I mean, it's much better than having to tighten all those screws, right?
Did you even look at the instructions at all?
The ones I found online were a lot shorter.
I don't think that's a good idea.
Wow, I guess you just know everything with your big instructions.
I would suggest caution with any design that wasn't tested extensively in a lab.
Ooh, fancy lab, Mr. Fancy. Well, mine works, and that's all I know.
So that thing actually produced water?
You tell me, buddy.
I will tell you, it did not.
It's probably better than water.
No, I'm sure it's great. But seriously, Sam, I wouldn't drink that.
Don't tell me what things to drink.
I'm sure it's a really great machine, but...
I'll tell you what I know. It smells like Dr. Pepper, I've invented unlimited Dr. Pepper.
I don't think that's the color Dr. Pepper is supposed to be. Why don't you send it onto the shuttle down to the lab and we can let you know?
You know, you really get defensive when I'm not dependent on you and your lab.
No, I just don't think you should drink whatever that liquid comes out of the box you built from the diagrams you found on the internet.
Isn't this America? Don't I have that right?
No, I'm in America. You are on Mars. Please do not drink whatever that is.
I'm thinking it's probably like water, but without all the toxins, and I'm going to be a multi-billionaire.
Water doesn't... Do you know what a toxin is?
Look, you have your opinion, and I'll have mine. Can we have a civilized disagreement?
The definition of a word isn't an opinion.
That's your opinion.
No, wait!
To nobody telling me what to do.
Sam, no, no!
NASA to Mars, NASA to Mars, do you read me? Colin is Karen, is that you?
Am I Karen? Am I Karen?
I'm just confirming that this is your report.
This obviously is my report, but I'm not going to be giving it to you. Not if you don't even know that I'm Karen.
So you would prefer not to give a report today?
Oh, I'm giving one, all right. Nothing's working.
Wait, what do you mean? Is something broken down? Karen.
The entire system here has just gone bananas.
Wait, Karen, which system? This is very important. Is it one of the life support system? Has the dome been breached?
It's like I'm talking to myself here.
What code is displaying? Has anyone done their manual override?
Oh, just try again, one of these bozos to lift a finger. No, sir.
Karen, please, I'm begging you. You may have only minutes of oxygen left. Is this an issue with any of the essential systems?
I don't know about how you people do things over there. I consider customer service essential.
You're not a customer, Karen.
I know you sure as heck aren't treating me like one.
I think I just saw my whole life pass before my eyes.
Does that life of yours include the ability to give refunds?
NASA is actually paying you.
That's what I thought you'd say, and that's why I'd like to speak to the manager.
The manager?
Yes, I'd like to speak to the manager.
I'm kind of manager of aerospace engineering here at NASA.
Well, I don't need any of my aerospace engineered. I need someone who can take care of this problem. I specifically requested some Funyuns, and they never arrived.
What do you mean they never arrived? If the shuttle didn't get there, we would know.
They must have delivered it to another planet or something.
That's literally impossible.
And another thing, the air here is really dry up here. And as someone who prefers soggy humidity, I think the least you could do is give me an upgrade.
You would like an upgrade of Mars?
I think it's only right.
So you would like to speak to the manager of Mars?
I have to tell you, I plan on posting an extremely detailed Yelp review of this entire experience.
Yeah, you know what? I'll put him on right now. He's definitely real.
Finally!
I'm totally not hanging up. I'm giving you the manager.
What is your full name so I can get you fired?
Just stay in line, no matter how long it takes.
Well, this is simply unacceptable.
NASA, do you read me? Do you read me, NASA?
Loud and clear.
This is Charlie from Mars. Thank you very much for allowing me to call you today.
Of course. I was just surprised to hear from you. We weren't expecting your report until tomorrow.
Well, I thought perhaps it would be wise to speak to you now as I'm in what I suppose you might call a predicament. I'm filled with intense rage all the time.
Oh, that sounds unpleasant.
And I fear that my sanity is beginning to fray.
Now, Charlie, let's remain calm. I'm going to ask you a few questions. Are you on edge because of the vastness of the great void of the universe?
Well, sort of. It's a crumbling of the will, a slow unraveling.
Is it the isolation from the rest of humanity?
Yes, 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 with only us and the dishes in the sink for 3 days that he doesn't even have the decency to rinse.
Now, I don't want you to panic, but I think it could be space madness.
No. It's definitely my roommate.
What?
Even if humanity is far away on Earth, we are still human beings, aren't we? And we owe each other whatever is left of civilization, don't we? We cannot put another human being in a place where they accidentally touch a piece of squishy pasta in the sink. We cannot. We cannot.
Wait, so you are having a problem with the colonist sharing your living pod?
Look, she was fine all through training on Earth, but this place has really made him something else. It's made him something pitiless, something evil.
Look, I know this sort of thing can be very frustrating. When you talk to him, he said no to doing dishes?
Well, I definitely implied that I was not happy. I looked at the sink. I sighed really loudly. Nothing.
This is not space madness. This is being passive aggressive.
Well, I don't want to seem bossy.
Well, we're trying to run a Mars colony here. Ask him to do the dishes.
I was just thinking of throwing us both out of the airlock.
That's murder. Ask him to do the dishes, Charlie.
Well, I guess. I really don't want to make it weird, you know?
It's already weird, Charlie.
But he ate some of my Oreos, and I suggested he get his own Oreos, but he's like, my Oreos never arrived. What am I supposed to do? I think I'm going to have to resort to something extreme.
Charlie, what are you saying?
I'm going to have to leave him a note on a post-it.
I've got to tell you, Commander, I am a bit concerned about morale among the colony.
What are you so worried about? We're having a great time up here, doing experiments, processing data, using the squeegee on the dome. It's like a vacation up here.
Well, they don't seem to be getting along at all. They're not talking to each other, and there's not even any work being done towards growing the eggplant.
That's what I said. They just won't listen.
And it looks like some of the deliveries from the shuttle aren't making it to them.
What are they talking about? That's impossible. I'll look into it. But you know, people always find something to complain about.
I guess that's true.
Especially regular people. Non-astronauts, I mean. They started a softball league. What can you do with people like that?
I mean, to be honest, the morale of my team in NASA is getting pretty low, too. I guess I just hope I could give everyone a good experience.
You know, it was a great experience. Last night, we had a colony council meeting, and we decided on a new name for the colony.
Ah, how wonderful. Democracy at work. Tell me, what did you come up with?
After a long and contentious debate, we decided on... New Jersey. I even got a commemorative t-shirt to remember it. This is my new Jersey.
Oh, that's...
New Jersey. Everyone's really happy with it.
Great. As long as all of you are happy. I'm happy for you guys.
It's a great name.
For whatever reason.
It's a great name.
I've got to get back to my data.
Don't worry about a thing, Doc. We got it all under control here.
NASA, ground control to Jess. NASA, ground control to Jess. Do you read me?
Yes, I read you.
Let's go ahead and get your report. So, you mentioned that you were going to try some of the experiments on Martian soil so that we can begin growing an eggplant.
Oh, do you still want that?
Of course I do. What are you talking about?
Oh, no. It's happening. It's happening again.
Are you okay?
Oh, sorry, reflex. A couple days ago, Charlie, who shares my living pod, developed an allergy, I guess, to headphones, and I guess he only likes one song, one incredibly catchy song. It's fine.
So about the eggplant?
Oh, I thought we weren't doing the eggplant anymore, but I think I did something that's going to be pretty... Stop!
You seem distracted. Want to ask him to turn it down?
Hey, buddy. Can you, like, just give us a second of music? NASA on the phone. Thanks, Rumi. Please, for the love of Pete, leave it off. I'm begging you. Okay, so I haven't really done any experiments or slept in 4 days. What I did do is this.
That is some cups.
I call it Castle Cuppington.
Okay, Jess, may I ask why you made a big tower of cups rather than complete the scientific research requested by NASA?
Well, first of all, I mean, look at it. It's awesome. Second of all, I cannot concentrate on anything but that song. It's been days.
I know the conditions aren't optimal, but it's really important. It is really hard. Is it really that hard to look? My career is riding on this, Jess. I need you to, wow, it just keeps going, doesn't it?
All I can do is stack in rhythm.
Our team needs this eggplant.
I try to write the data, and I look at the paper and I've written the lyrics.
Look, I guess, she really can't use any kind of headphones.
Right? That's what I'm saying. Hey, Charlie, throw the phone in there. I don't understand why he's doing this. We used to have, like, fun bonding time. We were just boring together, and now there's cryptic functions everywhere.
No, PhD. Dang it. Look, we need to go to another room.
I'm actually kind of afraid to go in the kitchen. Whenever he's in there with me, he keeps just jerking his head towards the sink and timing.
It could be space madness.
That's what I thought too. I mean, I haven't been able to do my dishes.
Wait, I think once before the song started, there was something. I think there is some causation. Compound. No, I think we need to do your dishes and go talk to Charlie about your post-its.
Really?
Maybe your only shot.
I don't know, but I'm willing to try anything.
Wait, before you go, NASA has one more thing to ask you, Jess.
Yes?
Please knock over that cup tower. It's gonna look really cool.
5, 4, 3, 2. NASA to Mars, NASA to Mars, Quinn, do you read me?
I read you, and I read your aura, which is burnished with purple today.
Okay, well, I suppose I'd better take your report. How are you feeling?
I'm enjoying a marvelous clarity. Doctor, and yourself?
Oh, thank you for asking. I'm a little tired, but it's very nice to hear that someone is actually enjoying the experience at the colony.
I'm just really trying to live in the moment, you know? Really appreciate an extraordinary opportunity this is.
Yes, that's exactly what I've been trying to tell the others. I know a motivational speaker would be a good addition to the group.
The opportunity to be here on beautiful Mars?
It's incredible, isn't it?
The opportunity to grow a community from a seed to a mighty redwood tree?
Yes, thank you.
The opportunity to really grow my side business selling awareness vitamins?
What?
Awareness vitamins. They're vitamins for awareness. Well, they're regular vitamins I put in a cool jar.
And you've been selling them to other people in the Mars colony?
Well, trying to. I've only gotten 3 people so far.
You absolutely cannot do that.
Oh, do you not approve of awareness?
No, I don't approve of you selling people fake nonsense in the middle of my space mission. NASA could get in enormous trouble.
Did you want a cut?
No, I want. I don't know what I want, except that I want you to never do that again. It's incredibly unethical.
Of course, I won't. I'm out of vitamins. You know, I actually ordered some Tic Tacs to use instead, but I don't think they were ever delivered.
I keep telling you people that's not possible. Did I do something wrong in some other life? Am I being punished for something?
I'm just planning to multiply my income stream.
I thought you were. I don't know, spiritual or mindful or a hippie or something.
Well, on Earth, I was a motivational speaker / life coach / yoga teacher. But my dream was always to start a side business selling whatever.
3 people bought this from you, you said? How? Why? They're in space. They don't have money. You can't buy anything.
Charlie actually traded me her emergency oxygen tank.
What? Why?
I'm reading some dark energy in your aura right now.
Yeah? You're out of business for good.
Did you want me to give Charlie his oxygen tank back?
Come on.
Okay. You know? If you're really stressed out, you should really try yoga. It helps you let go of the material things.
I think I better let go of the skull.
Robin, do you read me? Come in, Robin.
And who might this be?
You know that it's NASA. And who did he hope to speak with?
I'm just saying what's on the sheet. It's Robin Jones.
Nobody here by that name.
Robin, I'm the foremost expert in my field in aerospace engineering. I'm not going to say the thing you want me to say.
My name is Thrace Malamar.
Yeah, that.
Look, I said I wanted to start wearing an eye patch, and you said no.
I don't want you running around up there with no depth perception.
I said that while in space. I prefer to be employed as a bounty hunter, and you said no to that too.
Nobody read the information packets, did they?
So the least you can do, Doctor, is call me by my space name.
You know what? Fine. Why is it Thrace Malamar again?
The last name of Starbuck and Battlestar Galactica, plus a delicious cookie that sounds like Star Wars. I've been thinking about Malamars a lot. By the way, the box I requested never arrived. Could you check up on that?
I keep telling you people, it's impossible for the snacks to just not arrive. The shuttle is programmed to go to one place. It's not possible.
Seems like you ought to put a bounty on the case, no?
No. Okay, look, Rob, I mean Thrace, Mr. Malamar, here's the thing. It's costing several $1 million for you to be on Mars. I really need to show NASA something. I need the eggplant.
Well, I'm sorry, but I really can't work with these people.
What's the problem?
Well, first of all, they're all from Earth.
Where else would they be from?
All I'm saying is, if I wanted to meet people from Earth, I could have just stayed at home and tried to flirt with everyone at GameStop again.
Oh, boy.
I mean, is it too much to ask for one attractive alien with all human features besides slightly different ears or something? And maybe they just don't know how to love.
Look, we all watched a lot of Star Trek as a kid and are hoping for alien spouses who we could teach to love. I know that's why I work for NASA.
Too bad you guys haven't found any life on other planets.
Well, actually, I mean, no, of course not. Too bad.
Disappointing.
I know, buddy. So do you think you could try to work with the others of a colonist?
But none of them are even robots.
Well, the Mars rover is kind of a robot.
It doesn't make witty commentary.
Neither do you, Robin. Have you thought about that? Listen, you're relying on everyone else to make this epic space opera. You're living it. You're in the second colony to ever be on Mars. It's an adventure of a lifetime.
I mean, I guess, but how can I have an adventure of a lifetime in a place that apparently we have to call New Jersey?
Is that what this is really about?
How could they? We could have went with so many cool names, and that's what they went with.
Robin, I can't believe I'm about to say this, but I actually agree with you.
You do?
Literally anything else.
I guess I didn't think there'd be so much collecting data on my adventures.
Me neither, buddy. Me neither.
Okay. I guess I'd make the best of it. Thanks for talking me down, man. That was really nice of you.
Okay. You okay?
Sure. Don't worry about me.
Hey, Robin.
Yeah?
What if I told you that one of your fellow colonists is actually a robot who needs your help?
Yes, I knew it. Is it a Terminator? Is it Karen?
That's for you to find out. Just play it cool. Grow an eggplant with them, and all of us will complete our mission.
Okay. It's Charlie, right? No, it's probably Karen.
Goodbye, Thrace Malamar, and good luck.
Mars to ground control. Mars to ground control. Do you read me?
What is it, Charlie? Did you finally throw Jess out the airlock?
It's me, Charlie, from Mars.
Yes, I know. What new nightmare have you devised for me to deal with?
Well, look, so first of all, I'd like to apologize for the Macarena from earlier.
Well, I suppose that's really more of Los Del Rio's job, Charlie, but I appreciate it all the same.
Second of all, Quinn gave me back my extra oxygen, so you don't have to worry.
Literally the least he can do, but okay.
Third of all, I believe this time I am truly in the grip of space madness.
Oh, great. What ridiculous thing are you about to say?
It's because of the eggplants.
What about them? There are no eggplants. I've been begging you people to grow me just one eggplant and you won't. I assume because you either hate me and the docs or you just don't care.
See, that's what Jess said. He came in with a stack of post-its I left around the house and we started talking.
That's kind of nice.
I know, but he said that you said that we are supposed to grow eggplants.
How many times?
Well, the commander told me that he's deathly allergic to eggplants.
Wait, what?
It's literally the only time he's ever spoken to me. I asked him if we should grow anything else, and he said to leave that stuff to the astronauts. Unless I imagine it. Is it the void? The vastness? Has the space madness taken hold?
On the contrary, this is the most sense things have made in a long time. Thanks, Charlie.
Nassau, do you read me? This is anonymous. This is an anonymous caller.
Hi, Karen.
It's not Karen. It's a different...
Karen, this is your camera. I know it's you. What's going on?
I'm not going to get any trouble, am I?
That's kind of amazing since you clearly enjoy getting other people in trouble.
Here's the thing, though, Doc. I've been thinking. I've been thinking a lot. All my life, All my life, I've asked to speak to the manager if I felt that I wasn't getting what I wanted. I liked it, and I was good at it. But something's really fishy around here. And I mean very fishy. And I said to myself, Karen, what if you spoke to the manager of this colony about things that affected other people besides you?
Oh, geez. Poor Commander Fillion.
Sorry, buddy. I think in this situation, the manager is you.
Oh, no. Look, everyone here at NASA is taking your concerns very seriously.
We didn't name the colony New Jersey.
What? Oh, what do you mean?
It's a terrible name and everybody hates it.
Well, some people must have liked it because it's what you voted on.
That's what I'm saying. I don't think Commander Fillion really counted the votes. For some reason, that nerdy guy, Robin, really wanted to be my friend all of a sudden.
Ah, yes.
But he kept talking to me, and when he mentioned New Jersey, we realized neither of us have voted for it. My vote was for Costco, after my favorite place on Earth. His was for Moisture Farm, which I think is actually worse.
Well, I'm glad the two of you are working together. But what are you saying?
I'm saying you should keep an eye on Commander Fillion. Something's not right.
Let's not jump to conclusions, Karen.
Oh, I'm jumping, am I? Huh? You're an authority on jumping now? Well, let's see what your manager thinks. No, wait. No. Pardon me. I'm growing as a person. Just keep that in mind. I was never here.
Bye, Karen.
Commander Fillion, this is Dr. Weaver, NASA. Do you read me?
Hey, it's the doc. Yeah, I read you loud and clear.
I'm starting to wonder if I've read you clearly at all.
What's that supposed to mean?
I've been talking to the colonists.
Oh, I know. They're the worst, right?
They are the worst. And I think they're onto something.
Be careful now.
You know what happened to the supplies that went missing from the shuttle.
Be careful now, Doctor. Are you implying what I think you're implying?
I didn't imply it. I said it directly.
How dare you?
Colony name election.
How dare you?
You told them not to grow eggplants.
How can you say such a thing? I am burning with righteous integrity. I am so offended that you would say such a thing. I can rip this place apart.
Are those Oreos?
No.
I mean, those are definitely Oreos. I mean, the very Oreos Charlie said he never received.
No, those were my Oreos. I don't know what happened to Charlie's.
Wait, and there, by your shoulder, those are Funyuns.
No way, that can explain!
I think I've seen enough.
Come on, Doctor, we went to training together. We are so much better than these fools. We deserve some snacks for putting up with them. Come on, who cares?
I care. I'm living my dream right now. My job is establishing a Mars colony, and maybe it isn't exactly what I thought it would be, but I made it happen, and now we have a responsibility to these people. If they're fools, they are our fools. Why should they listen to us if we're hoarding their Funyuns?
I'm the commander, and they're not.
Not anymore. I've held a real vote with the colony council this time, and they voted that you're fired. The shuttle will be coming tomorrow to relieve you of your duty.
Wait.
Lots of explaining to do when you get back to NASA.
New Jersey is a great name. We all know it. It's the great name.
Goodbye, Commander. Or should I say, Mr. Fillion.
Admit it. It's a great name.
Ground control to Mars. Ground control to Mars. Do you read me?
I read you, NASA, loud and clear.
How's the weather up there, Doc?
Aw, there's no weather under the dome, you old so-and-so. It's a perfectly controlled atmosphere of my own design.
I know, just joshing, but really, how's it going?
I just... Every time I think that they really voted for me to be the new commander of the colony, I get really emotional. I just love space so much.
Please don't start crying, Dr. Weaver.
I just really, I mean, it means everything. And I live on Mars.
Okay.
And Karen was right that the air is very, very, very dry, but it's still just so majestic.
So anyways, how's that colony of yours going?
Well, you know what? We voted again, and we decided to stick with New Jersey.
Wait, really? After all that?
Yeah, it kind of grows on you after a while if you stick with it, like the Macarena.
Speaking of things growing on you, how's that eggplant of yours going?
The real important thing we're growing here is a new way of life, a community, a civilization.
No luck?
Yeah, well, it turns out that growing eggplants here is surprisingly difficult. But space is the final frontier, and tomorrow? Why? Tomorrow, we'll try your hand at green beans.